One of the best movies from the Soviet Union. It is the 1960 movie by Mikhail Kalatozov, Letter Never Sent. Let's take a look at why you should watch this movie and what makes this movie amazing coming up next. So Kalatozov made this movie after the great The Cranes Are Flying, and this movie debuts in 1960. I've always viewed this movie as a parable. The story is basic. Four scientists go up to Siberia on the taiga during the summer to look for diamonds. It's a scientific expedition ostensibly to make the Soviet Union great and rich. If they find diamonds, as the scientists say, there'll be a new industrial revolution, and the Soviets can get ahead in the space race and other technological races in the world at this time. As well, this is just a mission for scientific discovery. Nevertheless, passion shows up throughout this movie, including the main character, who you see writing to his love, Vera, with flames over the screen, layered over the screen to showcase his dying love, his romance, the flames of Eros, and so on. Plus, the other three scientists involved, there's a love triangle between them. Two of them are married, but the other one really loves the woman, and we find out during the course of this, well, the characters find out that he loves her too. So you have a scientific expedition with passion and love involved, and the question at hand during this sort of modernist to postmodernist transition, although I know this is the Soviet Union, but nevertheless I think it's here, is the question of whether science is legitimate as an enterprise, whether humans, who are passionate and erotic sorts of creatures, irrational, delusional, lots of dream sequences in this movie, whether they can actually do something as rational as science. And then there's a question of whether scientific expeditions or science itself can succeed when humans are so fragile and frail and nature is a dominant force. This movie showcases Siberia as a place of beauty and just luscious, gorgeous nature during the summer. But of course, these characters run into all of the problems you could out in the woods or out in the here the taiga. Those include lots of rain, lots of water, but especially, and during the middle of the movie, this is semi-spoiler alert, a humongous wildfire showcasing some of the most beautiful camera work I've ever seen. The wildfire plus what Siberia is known for later on, snow. And this is sort of a humans versus nature movie with science almost failing, the Soviet state almost failing. And of course, once you get to the end, you'll see whether nature dominates humans or whether humans can overcome nature. This has been a classic sort of setup for all kinds of movies, especially Hollywood loves to do these. But here you've got the Soviets actually talking about this and dedicating this movie to pioneers, as the opening dedication says, who struggle for discoveries, and especially for the Soviet people, who I think this movie is supposed to showcase the emotions and the struggles of Soviets, the Russian people in general. This feels a lot like angsty Russian literature to me. Now, besides the parable, the music in this movie is really great. I really enjoyed it a lot. But the visuals are the highlight of this movie. For those of you who are video makers, creators, wannabe movie makers, you have to watch this movie. There will be a shot, and probably 10 shots or a dozen shots in this movie, that will inspire you. You will be asking yourself, how did Kalatozov pull this off? And remember, this is 1960. This movie looks a lot like the style of, say, Quaron from Children of Men, or Gravity, or Inarritu from The Revenant. These modern movie makers with, you know, huge budgets, great pieces of camera technology. But here, back in 1960, Kalatozov was doing this with cheaper technology, and it looks great. The handheld cameras that sort of go through the forest with the characters, these huge, long tracking shots, especially through dangerous situations like the fire in the forest, for example. One of my favorite scenes is to watch how the camera goes through, glides through this forest, walks through it with these characters under fire, literally. These very long shots that on, I think, helicopters that pull back and show the landscape, the opening shot and the closing shot of the movie both have this type of shot in them. Very extreme close shots or very close shots in this movie of characters, which you get up in their face. It's a very intense and personal movie. Lots of angles, as camera angles as well. And nevertheless, even though you have close shots, you still see the landscape and you get the characters' emotional reactions and you feel for them with the landscape involved, it's very hard to do the combination of getting a close shot with landscape stuff going on, but Kalatozov pulled it off. So whether you're a viewer or a movie maker, video maker, this movie will inspire you. You will be in awe of it. I think to watch this with open eyes and to think about how he made this, each shot, how he put the shots together, and then to realize this is 60 years old at this point, is really remarkable, and hope will make you think about modern movie makers with humongous budgets not able to make shots like this, not able to put shots together like this. Why can't they, given that he was using more, as we would say, primitive technology? And why can't we do better than he does with our better equipment? Good question. I have to show you some of my favorite shots and sequences from this then. One of them is when the scientists are looking for diamonds and they're working very hard. The sequence begins by looking to me like a piece of communist propaganda. Everybody in the Soviet Union is really hardworking, conscientious. They value labor and labor for the state in particular. But then the sequence just segs into some over-the-top madness about like, working so hard, there's so much fire around, and this camera moving around with the fire. It's beautiful and haunting, and maybe it's mocking that propaganda. I'm not sure about that. But I just really am in love with this particular sequence. And then, spoiler alert, my favorite shot of the movie, it's a little hokey, is when the main character is lying down and you think he's dead. And then the men from the helicopter descend, and they descend in silhouette onto his head as he's lying down. He looks like a Gulliver of sorts. This enables a death and resurrection parable then, in the end. And the question is, what does this helicopter descent mean? The gods from the sky coming down to wake him up, to go into his mind and wake him up. But the gods here, of course, are the Soviet authorities who are rescuing him. So maybe it takes the state helicoptering in to rescue the individual and make him more rational or make him alive. There's a lot of ideas possible in this shot. And the final sequence in which his character is left for dead, nature's already almost destroyed him, but maybe the state or technology from above with his helicopter is going to save him. It's really great, fascinating imagery. Play around with it and think about what it means, especially for perhaps the Russians and the Soviets, or just human beings in general, and civilization versus nature, those themes coming up in the movie. The film is eminently rewatchable because of the visuals and the music together. You don't have to worry about the characters of the plot even. Just enjoy the ride in this humans versus nature struggle. This is one of the best movies that depict that very thing, I think. So for that reason, and all the others in this video, this movie I think is great. What do you think of this movie? Please let us know in the comments and subscribe to this channel for more great content. Thank you. Have a great day.